I am Bill Courtright with Living Right with Bill Courtright, and this is the Stress Mastery Podcast, where we take you from the science to the spirituality of stress mastery.
Hello, and welcome to another episode of the Stress Mastery Podcast. I am Bill Courtright, and I am here with the motorcycle super millennial, How you doing, buddy? David Barreto.
How's it going? Kind of a cool name.
Motorcycle millennial is here. So, how's everything going with the new bike?
It's going good. It's going good.
Your mom's not
sore.
Your mom is good. Your body's sore, right? Not used to maneuvering it and everything else.
Yeah,
and that
entire body sore.
New muscles and that. So this week, our topic is commitment. And yesterday's Millennial Monday, David talked on why millennials overcommit. For today's Health Huddles, we're going to discuss the commitment of health. Wednesday's Meeting the Minds, we'll talk on the commitment to you. Connection Thursday, we're talking on Revelation. And Friday, we will continue our book study of Wayne Dyer's Wishes Fulfilled. Before we get started, in the community, those that are in the Stress Mastery community, Lesson 2 in Module 5, Focus, will be posting later today. And this lesson is going to be on conscious mind management, and it's going to give you some pointers on how to disengage the ego and take control of the conscious mind, because that's everything when it comes to focus, and I'll explain that in the lesson in the video. Do you have anything, David?
No, that's all I had.
So this week, our topic is commitment, and today let's discuss the commitment of health. So commitment is defined as the state or quality of being dedicated to a cause or activity. So there's that word, state, again. State is your energy that you are in any moment. When one is committed to anything, that means they are dedicated to action. To be committed, you must be connected head, heart, and hand. The commitment to health would look like this in connection. Head. If committed to health, you would gather knowledge in the head. You would set your goals and create a plan. In the head, you would have clarity of what health is, and many times, this is the problem when we talk about creating commitment of health. If you do not have clarity of what health really is, your aim, focus, and behavior will be chaotic. And I do think that this is a big issue. And I think this is a big issue because people really don't know what health is. They say they're healthy, yet they don't sleep well. They wake up tired. They feel stressed out. They say they're healthy. They're on 3, 4, 5, 6 medications. How can you have clarity if you don't know what health really is? Now, here's the challenge, David, and agree or disagree. The challenge is the professionals that are to help you get healthy don't have a definition of what health really is.
Yeah, and I'll say that from going through training and certifications more recently. I use none of it. Yeah. It's all taught from books, I mean, from years and years and years ago. And even then, it's not even the way the body works.
If health is defined as not being in disease, well, if you're not sick, you're healthy. But is that really what it is? Health has to be defined, I believe, by the individual. For me to be healthy, it's not what I weigh on a scale, look like in a mirror. It's what I feel like throughout the day. It's how I feel like when I wake up. It's that energy. That's for me. For me to be healthy, I gotta feel right. And my mind has to be sharp. I have to be able to concentrate, focus, and be able to accomplish what I set out to accomplish. That to me is health. So let's say you have this belief. Let's say if you believe, let's use an example, that health is, you have health when you weigh 130 pounds and your current weight is 165 pounds. So with this belief, you set a plan in the head to lose 35 pounds. Sounds practical, correct? Mm-hmm. Right? But let's look closer. You believe to be healthy, you must weigh what you did when you were 25 years old, 130 pounds. Your aim is to force the body to lose weight. Remember, our aim is set either in a force, restriction, or a growth expansion energy. We talked about this last week. Our aim is what sets your focus. So your aim sets your focus, which sets your behavior. That's how it always works. So your focus, but your aim is set to lose weight, right? Your focus becomes the weight on the scale. Your behavior is to do whatever it takes to weigh 130 pounds. Now, here's the challenge. When the aim is set in force, the heart is disengaged. So you are connected head-hand. Commitment to the plan is dependent on the action of the hand. And you have created this aim, focus, behavior tethered to the scale. So in the beginning, things are great as the scale goes down. Then you're going along and you hit a plateau. Now your aim is in force. Your focus is to make the scale go down. And this will drive your behavior to diet harder and exercise more. And this process puts the body in a famine state. The body is in a stress state. What happens? Metabolism shuts down. Fat is being preserved. Energy drops. In the thyroid, the T3 drops, our energy drops. Stress is increased, breaks down the muscle. Cortisol rises. Cravings are activated. Sleep is deprived. Your commitment to get healthy is tied to a belief you must weigh 130 pounds. Your aim is in force, a restrictive energy. The body is the body of calories, and you are forcing it to exercise. So the body is set for a certain number of calories and the force of exercise. Your focus is a scale going down. Your behavior is to diet and exercise harder and harder. After a week or two stuck on a plateau that no matter what you do, you can't seem to scale to budge. In fact, it has started to creep up. So you begin to lose your commitment. You skip exercise. You start sneaking food. And the biggest fear you have at this point is actually embarrassment. You made declarations to everyone, family, friends, coworkers, Facebook, that this time you were really going to get healthy and lose the weight. And when the scale was on its way on that downward track, you made sure to let everyone know you were losing the weight. And in that short period, you became an expert at telling the world the great secrets of losing weight. You ever seen that happen?
Man, that's happened to me. Boy, I remember I was posting consistently, and the moment it didn't hit my goals the same way I thought, I stopped posting, and somebody posted, "You haven't updated in a while." I was like, oh.
Yeah, you got called out. I was like, damn, yeah,
you're right.
So I'm sure people listening, this story must sound rather familiar, but understand around what happens. So our aim, every human being on the planet, and this is what we're going to be talking about in lesson 2 of that module 5 focus, I'm going to be talking about how this all works, how we're wired. Every human being on the planet gets what they aim for. Your aim is either set in expansive or restrictive energy. So we can go, it's either set in a green zone or the red zone, right? And your aim is actually what determines your source, your vibration, your energy. Nothing can rise higher than its source, because the aim you set and any goal you set sets your focus. And your focus are the thoughts you're holding in your mind. And though that focus will create your behavior. So to all those listening, I know that story sounds familiar, but to create a true commitment to health, you have to create proper connection of head, heart, and hand. There are two reasons. One, when head, heart, and hand are connected, you create integrity of action. You don't think about eating correctly, you just do it. This head, heart, and hand connection creates aim, growth, and focus on the plan of behavior of doing what is necessary for you to be healthy. Your belief of being healthy is very important. What does that mean? Because if it's a number on a scale, you're setting yourself up for failure. Well, number two, why you have to have this connection. When head, heart, and hand are connected, you connect to the perfect machine of the body. So remember, head, heart, and hand are the connection of the three brains. So when you make the perfect connection, the head brain will send and receive proper signals to repair, rejuvenate, and build optimal health. And two, the heart brain, which sets its variance and variability to dictate to the head brain to be either in the red zone or the green zone. It's only in the green zone, in a parasympathetic nervous system, one can create and find health. And number three, really important, is the gut brain, which is the key to commitment and proper action. For the gut dictates to the head brain whether your mood is good, whether you have well-being, or you're sad and depressive. Also, it is the gut brain that dictates to the head brain whether the metabolism is on or the metabolism is off. A working and healthy metabolism uses fat for fuel. When it's shut down, the body will not burn fat, and it will actually burn its own muscle in order to survive. So you got to think about these things, because a lot of people want to change their body, but that doesn't mean they're creating health. To lose weight and gain it back actually destroys health, because you've actually reset your fat set point, which is also held in the head brain. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it also goes back to, I mentioned it yesterday, that making commitments that you continue to fail on creates that habit, you know, within your program that you live with, and you become okay with it.
It's always, if you fail on a commitment and you can't commit, it's because your aim is set wrong. If you're setting the aim in force, in a red zone, if you're making a commitment out of fear, if you're making a commitment out of anger, if you're making a commitment out of, you know, something other than your higher energies, you're setting yourself for failure. So how does one build a commitment to health? First, you must set the head. The head will set the aim, either in that force or growth energies. The aim will set your focus. And these are the thoughts you hold in mind, and your focus will set your behavior and actions. So how do we set the head? And I'm going to tell you guys this. There is no other way of doing this. And I'm not going to profess to be the smartest person on the planet. I'm only going to profess to be a guy that's lived this for 35 years. Because number one, to set the head, get knowledge, real knowledge. You must not only understand how the body truly works, but you must understand the mind-body, body-mind connection. The knowledge is not about carbs, fat, keto, intermittent fasting, low fat, high fat. No. Knowledge is, first, how are we wired as human beings to survive? What is the hard wiring of the machine? That's the first thing. Every human being is wired the same. Second, you must gain knowledge on how to work with the body instead of against it. This sets the aim in growth if you're working in expanse and if you're working with the body and not setting it in force against. And third, for knowledge, you must gather the knowledge of how your body works, how your machine works. How does your body process foods? How does your body recuperate, repair? How does your body handles stress? So you got to know this. This knowledge is crucial if you are to break the old belief programs. You have to have knowledge of why your past failures that you talked about yesterday keep failing. It's because you don't have knowledge of why they didn't work. And I really do say that one of the most important things is, For me, I always wanted to know why something didn't work. Why didn't that work? Why? It's made common sense. This should work. I eat less calories. I should lose weight. Why didn't it work? And this is why. So that's important. You've got to, that's the number one thing in setting the head is, number one is you got to get the knowledge. Now, number two in setting the head, once you've got the knowledge, you then need to set a plan. You need to set a plan and goals. And this plan must be clear to create commitment of action. Clarity of what you want, not what others believe you should have or be, is key. What do you want? What is it that you're looking to do? Why do you want to do it? The plan must lead you into the goals, and the goal must set the plan. This plan must be set off the knowledge gathered. In other words, why are you unhealthy? Why are you overweight? Why are you tired, have low energy? Why are you in pain? Why are you on these meds? Why is your memory lapsing? Why is sleep disrupted? You got to have answers to that. Because those whys, the plan is about achieving the goal of optimal health. Well, to do that, you cannot achieve optimal health if you don't know what has disrupted your health. Mm-hmm. And that's kind of what we do. You got to ask, is it stress? Is it the stress response? Is one of the five organs that we talk about disconnected? Is it aging? And you have no genetic circuit. Because when we age, we don't have to age, by the way. Do you know there's no aging gene, right? People don't understand aging. Aging is, we have the survival network, the stress response, right? We age when the body can't repair itself. And the reason the body can't repair itself is because the DNA has been broken. And if that that DNA has been broken and it can't repair itself, then what happens is it starts changing the cell structure. So that's another whole show, right? But that's the truth. Is your health been disrupted because you're aging? And I'll give you an example. A woman that went into menopause, her physiology will change the way it processes carbohydrates. Have you changed your diet to match your physiology? If you haven't, you're going to create disruption, right? And then I think the last thing, what disrupts your health, you have to talk, is it your thoughts? Is it your environment? Are you too negative? Because that's all epigenetics. The epigenetics are not just your thoughts. They're your beliefs. They drive your behaviors. The subconscious controls the body. That's what epigenetics is. But epigenetics is also is your body getting what it needs so it can repair itself? That's epigenetics. These genes are designed to heal them, fix themselves. Now, once you have that, any questions you have then, Dave?
No.
And that? So once you have that, you're understanding all that, you can set goals. And these should be set in phases, starting with the goal achieved, that this process will be the connection to the heart. You have to set this in the goal to be achieved has to go in phases. And this is the process that makes all the connection. In the final phase, the goal achieved, what does this look like to you? What does this phase look like? What does the final phase look like? Mm-hmm. What do you look like? Describe it. Tell me what you look like. What does this feel like? Describe it. How does this serve? Describe it. Because you got to set this in phases to get that connection to the heart. You want to start with the final phase. You actually want to start at the end. Now, that's the first thing you set. Now, phase two, you might have to do a reset. If your body is disrupted and it's not commuting, you're not going to make... So let's say your body is... The thyroid isn't functioning and you want to lose weight. And your health, you want to get optimal health, you're tired. And you go on a diet and you're trying to figure things out. It's not going to work if you don't do a reset. You got to reset the thyroid to make sure it works. Does it need medical intervention? Because you can have a metabolically shut down thyroid, has nothing to do with medical. Mm-hmm. It's your body in survival state. So why? So that's phase. So phase one is you want to kind of describe the end, the final goal achieved. In phase two of setting this, you want to do the reset if needed. And then phase three is stepping into a system that fits and works with you. That's how it works. You've got to go into a system. Those are the phases. You have to be in a system because there is no diet that works. Not a single diet works. You have to go into a system that fits your physiology. And what's the purpose of the system? To create health, mm-hmm. to create recuperation. So now when you set the head properly, it will naturally lead you to the heart connection. And the second process of setting a commitment to health is to take the clarity of the head and what you want out of the desire energy into the growth energies. Here's where you set the aim, people. You set the plan, you set the aim. It sets the aim. If you fail to connect to the heart and only focus on the head, your aim will be in want. So your aim is still in force. You understand this? Tell me if I get too complicated with this. Because to me, this makes so much common sense, but I got to make sure it's coming out that way. So how does that look? Aim is want. Focus, thoughts are want. You're in force. Behavior is fear and stress. Setting the heart changes this because setting your heart begins with the focus on the heart's superpower. And what is that? Imagination. It's imagination. It's using your imagination. Children live in imagination. In fact, once you can learn how to live in imagination instead of knowledge, you will not have stress.
I live in imagination.
Yeah, you do. It's a good place to live. It really is. So in Robin Sharma's book, The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari, he talks about the still lake as a mirror. And he states, you picture, imagine yourself walking through the woods and you come to this lake and the lake is perfectly still. And as you look into the lake, you see your life playing out exactly how you desire. You see you with your body strong and healthy, you feeling your energy surging, you moving smoothly, no effort, no pain, in perfect optimal health. The heart is the connection to the super conscious mind. And this is a great technique. It's one of the techniques I use. Every single creation in the world began here with a spark and an idea in the heart and the imagination. And you got to see this. You have to see it. You have to master visualization. There's different techniques. But I like the technique of looking into the lake. A silent lake. Just a beautiful still lake, and you create the picture. Now, I'm going to allow, if you want, should I share my personal technique? We have time? Yeah. I'm going to share my personal technique for setting and closing my day. And the purpose of setting and closing a day is to make sure you maintain connection so you can have commitment.
I like how you ask how much time you have. Yeah. Because I know your routine is pretty.
Yeah, I'm looking. So it's important to set and close your day in heart. When you do this at the start of the day, your aim is set with your goals, desires as being. There is no more doing. And you have to consciously do this. And this is stress mastery. Finding the now, it's being. Now, closing the day connected to imagination allows the superconscious and the subconscious mind to work as you sleep. In sleep, there is no conscious mind interference. So my technique, which I share in the new book, The Illusion of Stress, is quite simple. It's what Paul Selig refers to as entering the higher room. So what I do, get started, I get relaxed. And in this relaxed state, I start to imagine myself walking up some stairs to a door. I open the door, to which reveals a bright light. Now, stepping through the door, there is my master teacher. My master teacher happens to be Jesus, with light surrounding him, with my guides and teachers all around him. Now, if I walk straight into the room, I go to what Robin Sharman calls the clear lake. If I walk straight into the room, I can go through this garden and I come to the lake. There, I do visualization. Now, if I feel I need more support on this day, I will walk into the room and I will veer to the right where I have my I am affirmations. When I go to the right, it's all in my imagination. I do my I am affirmations. I have a lot of them. It depends on the state that I want to be in. And if let's say there's something pressing issues, then in these pressing issues, I must let go of and understand. So then instead of going straight to the lake or to the right to I am affirmations, I will go to the left, which takes me to the lessons that must be learned. When I go to the left, lessons learned, I just go into a meditation and I ask the question, what must I learn? And this always comes back to me. And this process I can do very easily. I could do it sitting on a plane. I can do it sitting there. I always do it in the morning. This is what I do before I meditate. And this is how I close the day. Because to remain connected to the heart, you must continually break the stress loop and use the let go technique. To do this, you have to set your day in the green zone. And so that's how I set my day. Because if I start my day in stress and I'm in the loop, how can you break the loop if your consciousness is starting the day in stress? If you feel, and I had it happen this morning, in fact, I felt like time was pressing me because I slept in a little. And I felt time starting to press me.
Tell them what time you slept in.
Six. Yeah, still, that's life for me.
Yeah. Just to give people context.
But I was like, you know, and so I had to settle into that because I could see if time starts pressing me, well, then I'm not there. I'm worried about what I got to do. I got to get going, and I could feel the stress start to build up. So that's how I set that. Now, to remain connected to the heart, you must continually break that stress loop all day long. And to do this, you use the tools of the heart. And the tools of the heart, first is faith, where you remain in your picture, even if the outside world is seemingly attacking you. Again, the attacks are always a perception. They will always be a perception. And then the other tool is to stay in the heart connected is gratitude, giving thanks for everything. Now, what does that do? That allows me to stay in a green zone. Where does health take place? In the green zone. Only in the parasympathetic nervous system. Because in the green zone, it's the only way the three brains are connected. So now perfect digestion, everything happens. Now with the head-heart connected, it's the connection to the hand that creates the change process. But in order to keep that heart connected, you got to set the day and you got to close the day. You cannot just ramble through and go through because you know what most people do? They go on automatic pilot. And I talk about that in the lesson, in the new lesson in the community is, well, most people are living, they have 50 to 60,000 thoughts a day, and your thoughts set your focus. Well, most people are having the same focus every single day, which means they're having the same behaviors every day, which means they're stuck in the same aim every day. And the reason we have to break that self-improvement is something that is ongoing all the time because we have to take consciously breaking that. And so when the head, heart are connected, it's connection to the hand. It's about creating integrity of action. It's to attain optimal health is about consistency of action. To maintain optimal health is about creating a program of optimal health and then consistently taking care of yourself. This is why it is critical to live within a system that manages the lifestyle variables of health. The Paul's Plan lifestyle system that we have and launching next year, and it's available now, is a system that ties body, mind, body into practices that keep the head, heart, and hand connected, which is the automatic connection of head brain, heart brain, and gut brain, which is the connection to perfect health. So, what is needed? So, guys, anybody who wants to walk in and try the community, but those in the community know this answer already. What do you need to attain optimal health and really create a commitment? Well, number one, you got to know your purpose and values. And that's in module 3 in the community. And it's an exercise that you do and the coaches, and we come right back and we will give you your purpose and what it means and your values. But I'm going to tell you this, you must value health. If you don't value health, you will not take actions toward health. The moment that life becomes too busy, you're going to skip your workout. The moment that food becomes too hard, you're just going to eat whatever. You don't value your health. You've got to have a value in there. So number 2, the Pause Plan Lifestyle System is in the community. It's a full book. It's 200 and 20 pages, right? 220 pages that it explains everything on how the body works. Diet and exercise are in there. Recipes are in there. It gives you all the science in there. It gives you the resets. And you can also, and that's in module two, you can also do the wellness survey, and we will tell you where your body, how it's working. Then, number three, there's higher goal setting, and that's in module three. You've got to understand that to set goals, you have to get out of desire energy, and you've got to get into the higher energy, because your goal setting is going to set your aim. If your aim is set in force, then your focus will be in force, and your behavior will be in force, and you won't attain optimal health. And number four is the focus technique set, close the day, and that's actually the new one in module five. So the focus technique, and I'm going to teach that in that particular lesson, is in there. And number five is coaching, accountability. So as we begin the process of launching our stress mastery wellness coaching, you will have several options that you can do in coaching. One is full coaching. It's a 12-week program. It's set up with me working with a coach each week. And this works consistent of a plan incorporating the steps of stress mastery. So it's not just your body. It's these seven steps of stress mastery: personalized, purpose coaching, higher goal setting, and success principles to reset the subconscious mind and create daily accountability to get you through the testing periods. So that's full coaching. Then we have the program set up, and that's working with me and a coach to set up your pause plan, lifestyle system plan, and accountability for 30 days. And it what comes with a private session, and we will work with blood work and everything else in there. And number three option is community modules, guys. We have coaches, members, and this gives you access to all the teachings of stress mastery. It also gives access to me and the coaches and incredible members of all levels. And so you in there, you've got everything. It works on a computer. It works on an app. We have a live Q&A after every module. The modules are up to, we're on our fifth module, and modules keep growing. And we have discounts on advanced courses. And I know it sounds like a commercial, but everything we talked about, if you want to create commitment to health, you have to create connection. Otherwise, you can't create commitment. I know I went over a little bit. Anything you want to add, Dave?
The only thing I would say about this is, and I touched on it yesterday, is that overcommitting is also, like Bill said, is committing to your health, but a lot of people are committing to health in the wrong way. For me, years ago, I told myself I was going to fit in a pair of pants that was way too small. Months and months and months and months of dieting, exercising, things like that. I finally got to the weight that I wanted, that I think I would fit the pants, and it didn't. And I discredited all the hard work, all the blood work changes, everything like that. And that created this program of being tethered to something. And I think that's a big thing. If you're going to commit to it, the tethered outcome of it should match your purpose and your values, not a material thing. Like for when you commit to health, what is that commitment? What are you getting out of it? Energy, you know, freedom, things like that. Not I'll get girls, or I can fit in this clothing and I can look this way. It's the result that you're getting, not a tethered,
approval. Yeah. It's not the one of approval. And I'm telling you, the commitment to health, if you have children and you're not committing to your health, then you're not doing them a service. How can you help somebody else rise if you don't even feel good? Mm-hmm. That's where you gotta get deep on why do you want to make changes? Because change is not hard if you understand why you are the way you are today. That's the whole thing. You've gotta get some knowledge of why you do what you do.
I hear a lot of people say, I want to watch my kids grow old and stuff like that. You want to grow old with your kids, not watch them.
Yeah, what are you going to do? Sit down and watch them? And then you become
able to.
And you become a burden.
Yeah.
Right? So I know this is a weird show, but that's it for today's show. Our mission here is to create a shift in the planet. You can join us on this mission by simply like, share, and subscribe. Those links are right below the show.
This is Motorcycle Millennial signing out.
Motorcycle Millennial, the super millennial. As always, until next time,
stay inspired.